On Hot Copy this morning, Arnel Ignacio returns to the Overseas Workers Welfare Administration, or OWA, this time as its administrator. The former TV personality's appointment was confirmed by the palace Wednesday. He joins us this morning. Good morning to you, Arnel.
Good morning, Karen.
Well, congratulations, first of all, for being the administrator of the OWA. Why don't you share with us how you were appointed to this post? Do you know the president personally? Are you close to him? How did this happen, Arnel?
Knowing the president with regards to the appointment, I doubt it has anything to do with the appointment kasi as you've seen, I wasn't even in the campaign. But I say thank you to the president for the trust, and also to the secretary Toots Oakley, who also trusts me enough to recommend me as the administrator of OWA. So maraming salamat sa tiwala, and also of course my colleagues sa Overseas Workers Welfare Administration.
Okay, let's go back to a bit of your history in government. You were once with PAGCOR and
yes,
resigned, and you were once then reappointed. You were appointed to OWA, not as administrator, and eventually resigned. With these two posts under the Duterte administration, I know you had family issues then and you wanted to concentrate on family. Balikan natin yon, Arnel. Why weren't you able to actually fulfill your two appointments in PAGCOR and OWA in the last administration?
After I resigned from OWA, I was reinstated. Before I became the administrator now, under President BBM's administration, I was reappointed uli ako as deputy administrator of OWA. Mm-hmm. So it's like I never left OWA. Mm-hmm. So when I started working for government, it was a great adjustment. Mm-hmm. And family, it was a great challenge. Time management was a great challenge working for government. So dun sa aspeto na yon, Karen, medyo nahirapan talaga ako. Oh. But now that I'm fully adjusted here and quite loving my work, enjoying my work, and finding my very comfortable niche here in the Overseas Workers Welfare Administration. So hindi na rin siya parang trabaho, Karen eh. I look forward to the daily adventures I have with the OFWs. Napamahal na sa akin sila eh. So it's like just coming home.
All right. How will you run OWA differently? When you were deputy administrator, I went through the records and you had very you were very vocal at times, even during the hearing, on some of the procedures that OWA had done that you said were wrong. And one of those was a rescue mission in Kuwait. You said it was a crime that they didn't coordinate with Kuwaiti police. Now that you are administrator of OWA, what will be your priorities?
Ako, yung mga nasabi kong ganyan, siyempre bagong-bago ko. Now I've learned to temper my mouth.
Naiintindihan mo na ngayon.
Naiintindihan ko na, Karen. You don't always say things that you think is right. Now, these people in DFA, in my family, so have become friends of mine. Respect for them has grown in my heart. So we are a team. I've learned how to advance changes without being too vocal. Naintindihan ko na sila eh. Now, so ano lang ang ano? What can you expect?
Yeah.
I would like the OFWs to understand us more. Mm-hmm. Messaging is very, very important. Clear messaging is very important. That's why, kunyari, pag kayo ang nagsasalita sa ABS-CBN or GMA or other networks, ang bilis-bilis naiintindihan. Mm-hmm. Kapag ka kami nagsalita, hindi ba parang naguguluhan sila. Why? Because I think we are too technical. So gagawa namin ng paraan yan. We'll make it much, much simpler for our OFWs to appreciate the programs that are all designed for the benefit of our OFWs. Plus, the secretary, Secretary Tuts Opde, instructed, una niyang instructions, make the OFWs feel that the DMW, the Department of Migrant Workers, and OWA, pag pumunta sila dyan, that they should feel that it is their home, it is their sanctuary. No stories is too insignificant to be listened to. There will always be an ear, a heart, arms to hug them whenever they come to the DMW. There will be no...
Okay.
Yeah, sorry.
No. Arnel, I wanted to ask you because maraming OFWs ang nanonood ng ANC all over the world. So perhaps you can explain this, no? Ano ang jurisdiction at mandato ngayon ng OWA now that you have a Department of Migrant Workers? So, anong papel ng Department of Migrant Workers at ano specifically ang papel ng OWA, Arnel?
Okay. Ang OWA, gusto ko lang ipaliwanag mabuti. Welfare ang OWA. We do not take care of your documents. Like, kumisan ka rin, alam mo, ang hirap ang paliwanag, the OEC, the Overseas Employment Certificate, hindi po kami nagpo-process. DMW yan. But of course, pag nilapit sa'yo, Karen, hindi ka tatanggi, tutulungan mo pa rin. Pero for the sake of clarity, para rin hindi sila nahihirapan, no? DMW yan, dati POEA ang gumagawa. Passports. Ang passport po hindi ginagawa ng OWA. Ha? So huwag po kayong nagagalit sa akin kapag hindi ko kayo kayang bigyan ng slots.
No, it's very important that it's clear because it makes it more efficient for the OFW to. Sige, ituloy mo, Arnel.
Oo, tama. And again, I am encouraging our OFWs. Please, please, please. Total naman, nagmamarites kayo. Pagka marites, ang bilis-bilis yung buksan. Imarites nyo ang mga programs ng OWA. There are so many scholarship programs. We have scholarship programs even for those who are earning $600 and below. We can support you with $20,000 a year sa scholarships ng inyong anak. Yung EDSP namin, that's $60,000 a year. Mm-hmm. So, we have scholars who have graduated with flying colors and awards. Yung iba na doctor na, judge. So, take advantage of this. Messaging is very, very important. Clearer understanding of what OWA is there for you. Kailangan yakapin natin at maunawaan. We need all the help we can pagdating dito, especially pagka umaabot na tayo dun sa mga probinsya para hindi rin sila nabobola ng mga ibang mga nagre-recruit na kung ano-ano yung mga pinapangako. Please keep an open channel na pakinggan nyo yung OWA. Get to know us. Walang ayaw tumulong sa inyo pagdating dito sa departamento na ito.
Okay. And Arnel, will you be changing or streamlining OWA? I'm curious, will everybody be retained? Are you adding more people? How will it work under your leadership?
Streamlining, ang konti na ng tao namin. I don't think that is a wise decision to even cut the number of people working for OWA. Plus, what I would like to do is to find a way on how I can tap the retirees who possess very valuable institutional knowledge, institutional experiences, connections all over the world. They will play a very valuable part in the operations of OWA. Hindi natin pwedeng basta baliwalain itong mga nauna natin mga welfare officers, mga labor attachés. Karen, napakayayaman sa karanasan itong mga ito. And we will try our very best to make our workers understand na this is not just work, this is not just a vocation, it's basically pagkakapwa-tao. Your kababayan is in another country. Sino ang kakausapin niya? So, yun na nakaata sa amin. The mere action of somebody answering hello when they call you is very, very important. I'll be seeking the help of those with very, very deep experiences in this industry, and their knowledge will be valued.
Okay, so let's go back to it. Number one, the OWA has a very good scholarship program for the children of OFWs. Would you know offhand, Arnel, how much is the budget of OWA for scholarships?
A year. Basta dito, Ang OWA naman, Karen, we have a trust fund which takes care of these programs. So ito mga ito like the Education for Development Scholarship Program namin, 60,000 a year ang ibinibigay dito para sa mga nakapasa. Meron ka ng konti exam from the DOST.
But do you have an overall amount? Would you know it now? Or you're still waiting for the final budget?
Yeah, we are designing the budget for this. Okay. But ito naman ang gagaling ito sa trust fund ng OWA. So hindi ito masyadong mahirap. Eh, kaya lang ito lang. I'd like to also make it clear. Naka-slots ito ha. So when we announce that there are scholarships available, kunin mo na. Eh, pero pagka naubos ito, hindi ibig sabihin tapos na. Kumbaga inaayos lang natin ano, Karen, eh. Diba? Kunyari, naglabas kami 2,500 slots. Kumbaga, hurry and avail of the scholarships. Okay. Pero hindi pa tapos yun. Pag naubos yun, maglalagay pa ulit tayo.
Mm-mm. Okay, my next question, what is the role of OWA when it now comes to rescuing OFWs in trouble in other countries? Ano na ang papel ninyo dun, Arnel?
Gusto kong yung ibalita sa inyo na pinabuo sa amin ni Secretary Tuts Opre, yung ORCC, the Overseas Repatriation Command Center, para kung mayroong mga gustong mga umuwi kagad, if they have they're encountering problems doon sa lugar where they're working, ito na lang yung number na kanilang tatawagan, 1348. And I also urge our OFWs, whenever they're
Wait, is that 1348?
Yes.
So
yes.
That's 1348 they can call from the Philippines, or you mean from all over the world where they are 1348?
Pagka if they're in another country, dagdag lang nila yung country code and the area code. That's I think that's one. That's plus 632.
Okay.
If they're in another country.
Okay. I'll go on, Arnel. So may hotline na. May hotline ang OWA that's available sa lahat ng cellphone.
Yes.
You can call basta for repatriation. Okay.
Yan, meron na tayong Overseas Repatriation Command Center. Nandyan yan sa DMW. Mandyan 24/7. Okay. And kadalasan kasi Karen, ang ginagamit nilang ways to communicate is through FB Messenger, no? Ay makikiusap lang ako pagka sila ay nagse-send ng kanilang mga messages. Karen, mas madaling makatulong if they just put in their names, their mobile number, and where they are.
Correct.
Kasi most of the time, the salaysay is very long.
Ba-o.
And then they forget to tell you who they are.
Correct.
They forget to tell you where they are.
Uh-oh.
I mean, where will I look for you? Diba? I don't even know who you are. The whole story is there, but no identification, no way to get in touch with you. Plus, you forgot to mention the country.
You're right. So
meron pa, Karen, minsan sinasabi ko, nasaan ka ba? Dito lang po, malapit sa puno. Oh my God, sabi ko,
sa ang puno?
But you know what, Karen? Itong mga ganito kong kwento sa iyo, is what made them even more endearing to me. Kasi sino magtsatsaga sa iyong kausapin yan? But I don't know. I give time.
Okay, so that's the second one, rescue. You were already asked to put up that hotline, and it's sort of a task force. Would you say it's a task force, no? That's under OWA. Ngayon, paano yung OFW?
DMW.
Okay, paano yung OFW ngayon na bumabalik? They've lost their contracts, their jobs, and they need to start a business or they need some kind of support or financial assistance. Sa OWA rin po ba yon?
Ito ang maganda. DMW, yung ating reintegration programs na dating nasa NRCO, is a reintegration program sa atin. Ngayon, nasa DMW na yan. I think it's ASIC Benny, Legazpi, who takes care of this.
So hindi dati na sa OWA lalapit pag ganun. Dati kasi Arnel sa OWA. Remember, sa OWA hindi na.
Actually, it's the NRCO.
Oo.
Yung okay. Kunyari dito na sila, they'll stay here, ano? Pero ang naghati kaya dati kasi medyo nalilito sila. Meron kasi sa OWA, meron ding sa NRCO.
Yeah.
Yung mga active members namin, yan, amen. Ngayon, yung mga inactive, yung mga tinatawag nila minsan na hindi documented, NRCO siya. But let me talk about the programs.
Yeah.
Para doon sa mga na-distress who were not able to finish their contract and wanted to, you know, they changed their mind. I'm going to be staying in the Philippines and work here. We have of course, we still have the Balik Pinas Balik Hanap Buhay program. It is for the distressed OFWs. We train them if they, you know, if they have something in their minds to put up a business. We give them a startup capital of 20,000 plus a lot of guidance, of course.
Pero and hindi sa OWA lalapit yun. Sa OWA lalapit yun, yun, Arnel.
Yung balik Pinas, balik hanap buhay. Sa OWA yan.
Oh, good, good. OWA okay.
Oo. Ngayon, what is more exciting, itong tulong puso program ng reintegration natin. Ito naman yung sa DMW. Kunyari, ikaw ay talagang mag-i-stay ka na rito. Lima kayo na nakapag-isip ng doable, feasible na negosyo, the reintegration program will support you with a startup of 50,000 pesos. Ano to ha? Basta lima kayo, lima. Mm. Hanggang mga 1 million ito. And it's very exciting that marami na akong napuntahan na natulungan yung programa na yan. That's the Tulong Puso program. In fact, there's an island I visited. It's called the Alabat Island na na-finance namin yung kanilang mga hog racing industries. Mm. It's a wonderful program.
No.
Ano lang, kumaga ang hinihiling ko lang, Karen, sa ating mga OFWs, it takes two to tango. We provide the programs, we come up with the programs, trust these programs and come to us. No? Chicken mo rin, imarites mo rin kami, i-google mo kami. Sisikapin namin na mas maging reachable kami at mas maging madali kaming ma-contact, makapagpaliwanagan tayo.
Okay. Arnel, when I interviewed DSWD Secretary Erwin Tulfo on Head Start, I asked him, what kind of secretary do you want to be? And he said, I want to be the secretary that people can hug, they can touch, we're on the ground. What kind of administrator do you want to be for OWA? Sino si Arnel Ignacio?
You know, hindi lang siguro bilang administrator. Whenever you get to meet people, I would always want to leave a good memory. Each time you meet, like I get to meet you, Karen, I'd like you to remember me as a good memory. Okay yan si Arnel. Yung mga, for anything that, kung wala ka nang matawagan, si Arnel tawagan mo.
Mm-hmm.
That's what I am for the OFWs. I also would like to point out, hindi lang ako magsisilbi na parang kung ano yung gusto mo, ibibigay ko.
Mm-hmm.
I would like to add the direction to OWA that we should also be teachers.
Mm-hmm.
We should shepherd our OFWs. Hindi yung parang kang laging ang narrative mo, uy, kawawa ka naman. But that doesn't motivate I want them to discover the value of their experience. Can you imagine kung gaano kagaling ang mga naging training ng mga ating mga workers abroad?
Mm-hmm.
I'd like to mention, for example, you're an automotive mechanic in Saudi Arabia.
Yeah.
Remember, you take care of high-end cars.
Mm.
And these cars are very expensive to maintain dahil nga sa kakulangan ng mga taong marunong na bumuting-ting nito. We have a lot of OFWs can easily take care of this. So, marami pa tayong kwentong ganyan. So, yun ang gusto kong mangyari. I'd like to change the narrative. Ang OFWs natin magagaling, hindi ka nalugi. You're a Filipino. We are so loved all over the world. Puhunan natin yan.
Yeah. So, Arnel, may ibinilin ba sa'yo si Pangulong Ferdinand Marcos Jr.? May habilin ba sa'yo with your new appointment?
Ang habilin niya, binabilin niya kay sa aming secretary Tuso, okay, who's also so easy to love.
Mm-hmm.
No, ang binili ni presidente, hindi lamang OFW ang inyong alagaan. Extend this care itong inyong pangangalaga sa kanilang pamilya, especially the children. So OWA will be coming up before the end of the year. Several programs to take care of the children of our OFWs. Una na yung OFW Children's Circle. Magkakaroon tayo ng malawakang mga activities na ibibigay natin sa mga anak ng OFWs pagdating sa arts and culture, sports. Magbabanis ang pera. Bakit natin sila tuturuan magbanis ang pera? Because madali na nagpapadala. Oh, oh. And sometimes they just don't know how to spend it.
And maraming OFW rin, sa totoo lang nakausap ko, nakakalungkot, may utang.
Yes,
you know, hindi nila, they're unable to invest their earnings.
Kasi sometimes when you get to earn na hindi ka sanay. Kasi ang laki ng kinikita mo eh. Ang pakiramdam mo, lahat kaya mong bilhin. So we will do something about it and participate in the wiser spending, financial literacy. OWA will always be there. Yan ang mga bilhin sa atin ni Presidente. Para okay, mas maging malinaw yung direksyon.
All right. Well, on that note, I want to thank you so much, Arnel, for joining me today. Is there anything you want to announce that they can expect you in the next few days?
As soon as I end this quarantine, kasi ako ang na-COVID quarantine.
How many days are you now? Ilang araw ka na?
I think I'm on my fourth day.
Okay.
Ito, nakayakap ko yata. I don't know where I got it. Kasi every day I'm in the airport welcoming our OFWs. So as soon as I can work, they can expect that they can feel that OWA will be around, will always be around for them. Mm-hmm. And I think we're saying goodbye. I'd like to check out. Did I give you a good memory?
You did, and I was going to say, thank God you're okay. I mean, you're COVID positive, but you joined our interview. You know, I mean, some people actually lose their voice. They can't even do an interview. So it's nice to see that you're okay.
Oh, if Karen Davila gives you a chance to be interviewed, you better wake up. Tumayo ka, kung wala kang boses, find a way how to talk.
All right. Well, Arnel, we wish you well with your new post.
Maraming salamat sa iyo.